The bloody topic from Bong Joon, there were these five men, two of whom he and his followers managed to trash to pouring blood in 2014, September 2. And he seems very satisfied with his work. And when the police is coming to inquire him, he has this usual, he must be making fun of them because he's always using this totally absurd arguments why he was forced to attack them. It is that he is literally saying, they were sitting on my sofa and smoking cigarettes. So I was forced to beat them. And the police is like taking it as like a normal thing, like they write it down, and yes, this is a valuable argument to trash at night some five men and two of them into blood and beat them all night. It's a valuable argument, yes. So, and doesn't make sense, yes, because at midnight in the middle of the jungle, these five men were returning from India from work. That's the fact. That's all the families, their families and the villages, they know it. It's in the media. So how did they end up at midnight in Bong Joon's, in the middle of the jungle, when Nepalis are quite scared to go to the jungle at night because of the wild animals, because there are tigers, wild elephants, snakes. So, not normal villagers would just walk to Halkoria in the middle of the night, 6 or 10 kilometers through the jungle, and end up in Bong Joon's villa on his sofa and smoke cigarettes. It's so absurd that Bong Joon, he makes up these lies because I think he really wants to make laugh, a good laugh from all this stupidity because it's so absurd that no one can believe it, but the Nepali police believes it because he knows that he has in his hands everything and everyone because in the area, everyone was afraid of him. These Nepalis are very superstitious and they think that he has magical powers and also a lot of money. So it's the combination of superstition and bribes. And so we have these two men with pouring blood. And next victims, obviously, if they were killed, what is quite a big possibility because they disappeared many, many years ago in Bong Joon's own compound, and they were his nearest people. There must have been a lot of blood as well, and the description of how Sanchalal Voiva was lynched by beating to death. At the Maitri Puja 2015, just 3 weeks before the big earthquake. That description from two eyewitnesses is also that about lynching. So lynching obviously is a way to kill someone where blood is pouring. And Bong Joon himself was also lynching together with his men. I got an information from an insider about how Bong Joon's sister had been lynched just before that Maitri Puja, apparently. I don't have enough concrete information, but it was also the 2015 Maitri Puja when Bong Joon's sister was lynched with him and by those two torturers who tortured me, the Polish European Tomek Tarnowski Dorje, his main torture assistant in nearly every crime, and Darshan Subbalimbu. This is what the informer told me when I asked who helped Bomjon to lynch his sister. Because, you know, it's how Bomjon is doing these attacks. He could do it alone, he's strong enough, but he wants to involve more and more people so that their conscience becomes bad and they become desensitized and their conscience becomes paralyzed because he's keeping these children, monk children, who are forced to see all these attacks. So when something is happening on an everyday basis, then it becomes the norm for them. So the Tamang followers of Bomjon, they see enough blood all around. Every month, every 2 months, someone is attacked, killed, tortured, raped. So they became used to it. This became the norm. And also lying about it became the norm. So who knows how many victims did they already torture to blood and bruises and killed. We don't know about many people who are just disappearing. For example, people who have no families, no one is searching for them. And so this was also a bloody event, most probably because her brain became swollen from the beating, like a long time permanent beating on the head. It took many years for me to come over that. And the informers who were describing it to me, they didn't have the guts to go to the police and tell this as a witness. But I must be happy. I must be grateful that at least they told me the details, because there are many lies about the death of Manu. But somehow all Nepalis know that Manu had been killed by Bomjon. It's like in the open. The police doesn't care in Nepal, of course. They are bribed by the money of Vietnamese and Thai followers, and Canadian and Australian, New Zealand followers, US, Californian, Oregon followers. And so, why is it that every time Bomjon needs this blood? It's like, is he a vampire? Obviously, he's a kind of spiritual vampire because he needs that blood. But this is what we know, who had become his witnesses, I mean victims and the witnesses, and the attackers also know it. I just wonder whether those attackers, like the European Tomek Tarnowski Dorje, a man who I think even has a university, they never stop to think, never sit down and start to think about if all this makes sense, if this is still spirituality, what Bomjon is ordering them to do. But I think they are like zombies, they just don't feel anything anymore human, and for them it's just normal. And so there is a lot of blood around Bomjon. And then when I was his follower in Halkoria, then it's so ridiculous because there were these rules. Even now it's even more strict. When you go to Bomjon for blessing, then you are not supposed to eat meat and drink alcohol and smoke cigarettes just before it. And they should keep away from blood, and that is allegedly, I heard, I don't know if it's true, there is this habit in some ethnic groups in Nepal that they put a talisman for the children on the neck from the skin which was taken out from the, no, I forgot the name in English, they take out this skin from that and they dry it and they put on the neck. I don't know if it's true, but this is what Bomjon's followers told me, this kind of protection talisman. And that one such a person came to Bomjon for blessing and that he refused to bless him. And he told him that take down this talisman from your neck. I'm not going to bless you before it. So, that time when we were all brainwashed, we were thinking, oh, this was what they told us, the followers of Bom Jon, Bodhisattva Dharma Sangha, that he's so allergic to anything what is meat and skin and, from human or animal body, that he cannot bear to touch even anything. This is absurd because he can bear to touch his victims into blood and fractures. So this doesn't make sense, of course, for us. It doesn't make sense for the victims, the witnesses who would think a bit, but they don't. And the attackers who should think about this as well, but they don't. So the only ones who start to think about why Bom Jon is not allergic to seeing blood and touching blood when he is beating and torturing us are the victims. But there are hundreds of people who are members of these projects of torturing human beings, his human sacrifices, what I call human sacrifices. So people should start to think, how is it that he can manage? But we have a proof already, the September 2 beating, when you see the people, the men are with pouring blood. So how is it that Bon Jon followers are claiming that he cannot bear the nearness of anything bloody or meaty or body parts, and suddenly he doesn't mind to beat people into blood by his own bare hands or sticks? So this doesn't make sense, yes? And the other thing is that when Bom Jon kidnapped me, then it happened that I was just menstruating. And he forbid, I'm telling it in other videos, he forbid me to use my pads. So he kind of enjoyed that I was forced to be dirty and unhygienical and who knows how I looked like, yeah? So that was good for him. He liked the. It's also, he didn't allow me to wash myself. So obviously, I don't want to describe the. How it looks like and how you feel it, but it didn't. He didn't mind it, and like every Nepali spiritual person, Hindu or Buddhist, they are very careful about menstruation woman. She cannot touch them. She must be separated. Yes, there is a big deal about the chaupada in now in the media. This habit to segregate, to separate women who are menstruating because they are not ritually clean. I would not go so far, but at least I expected that he allows me at least to keep kind of clean so that my presence doesn't pollute His Holiness, but he didn't mind. He doesn't mind blood, be it menstruation blood or blood from attacked people. So where is this hypocritic allergy of talismans, which some of the talismans of some Nepalis are even having some kind of piece of meat in them, not just from the birth of the baby, but also like buffalo meat. Oh, they're magic, yeah. Nepalis like magic very much, so there are different dog meat or anything. Different ethnic groups have different magic and they wear talismans. And Bom Jon has this rule, everyone must put down the talisman at the gate, and only when all the talismans and all kind of protective ropes and I don't no robes, but these protective things that Buddhists and Hindus are wearing, everything must be put down. And there is a reason for that.